The Tale of Two Brothers. Once upon a time, there were two brothers. Their parents died early. Both of them lived together. The elder brother was hardworking, while the younger brother was lazy and was interested in playing. He did nothing all day. One day, the elder brother said to the younger brother, "Before our parents died, they left us a little property, but if we do nothing, we became penniless in the near future. So tomorrow, we will go in separate ways to find a job. When we become rich, we will come back to find each other." The younger brother agreed. In the next morning, two brothers said goodbye to each other and went in their separate ways. When the elder brother just got out of the village, he saw a field that was ripening. Every group of harvesters were hurrying off and harvesting. He instantly jumped down the field to help them. He harvested very fast. The field became clear wherever he harvested. All harvesters were satisfied with him. After harvesting paddy fields was over, they presented him some packs of rice. He expressed his gratitude to them and brought grain rice for preparing food on the way. He continued to walk. For a moment, he met a cotton field. While ripening cotton balls were covered all over the field, many people were absorbed in picking cotton balls. Scorching sun made their faces red hot and sweaty. Seeing that, he jumped down to help them. He picked fast and carefully. Cotton pickers smiled happily with him. After picking cotton balls was over, they presented him some cotton balls. He expressed his gratitude to them and exchanged cotton balls for clothes to dress. Then he continued his journey. Walking for a moment, he met an old man who had the white hair like silk thread and red skin like a Malagasy plum tree. Seeing him, the old man said, "I have a very precious pumpkin which needs water. Please help me to water it to keep it alive." The elder brother agreed to help him. Then he came to pumpkin field. As a matter of fact, he saw withered pumpkin on the field. There was a pair of buckets near that. He was hurried to bring the pair of buckets to carry water. The road to the spring was very far and rough, but he took pains to carry from this bucket to another bucket to water the pumpkin. After 3 months in a row, the pumpkin gradually became fresh and created flowers and fruits. First, a pumpkin grew very fast. Only during some days, they were as big as a king-sized basket. One day, the old man came while the elder brother was carrying water. He said, "You experienced a hard work to carry water from my pumpkins. I will present you the biggest fruit of the pumpkin to express my gratitude." The elder brother said thanks for the old man and stooped to pick up the fruit. When looking up, the old man disappeared. Too surprised, he used knife to cut the fruit into pieces to see what happened. He saw nothing but gold, twinkling and very beautiful gold bars. Knowing that was rewards that the old man paid for, he gathered gold bars and came back. As for the younger brother, after departing, he also met a ripe field. Harvesters also asked him to help them, but he said, "Harvesting rice will make me have a bad backache. Then he went away. Harvesters followed him with their eyes and scolded, "You lazy folk!" Walking for a moment, the younger brother also met a cotton field. Cotton balls were so ripe as they exploded and fell down the ground. Cotton pickers also asked him to help to pick, but he answered, "Picking cotton balls will make me have pain in my hands. I just can't." Then he went away. Walking for a little while, the younger brother met an old man and was asked to help him to carry water for his pumpkin. But the younger brother refused. The old man scolded him, "You lazy folk!" The younger brother did nothing. Then nobody gave him either rice or cotton. Without rice to eat and clothes to wear, he was so hungry, thirsty, and ragged that he approached the old man and begged for a pumpkin to have a light meal. The old man gave him an ugly pumpkin. Then, cutting it into pieces, there was nothing but soil. He felt ashamed and didn't dare to meet the elder brother again. Waiting for meeting the younger brother for a long time, the elder brother decided to go to seek him. The younger brother was found while he was laid low beside the pumpkin field because of being hungry. The elder brother brought him back to home, brought rice for him to eat, brought water for him to drink, and brought clothes for him to put on. Being fed well, the younger brother gradually felt refreshed. Then he told the elder brother about his story, about his decision not to harvest rice, not to pick cotton ball, not to carry water for the pumpkin. Hearing that, the elder brother said, "It is because you're too lazy to work, so you became nearly starved to death. If you take pains to work, you will become prosperous like other people." Hearing the elder brother's advice, the younger brother felt deeply regretful. From then on, the younger brother worked harder. Two brothers lived happily together.